There you go. Welcome back to our channel, guys. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad.
Rod Sr.
And we are
Bridging the Gap.
Yes, sir. The boys is back. We're here to do another album reaction for you guys. And I'm super excited. First, I want to say thank you for everybody for the well wishes and condolences to my friend Hans. I really appreciate that. Yeah, tough day, tough days ahead. But yeah, I appreciate everybody dropping those doves and showing love to my boy Hans. Also, appreciate everybody that's been supporting us on Patreon. If you are interested in watching our videos uncut and complete with no edits, please feel free and pledge your support to our Patreon. We really appreciate it. Mm-hmm. If you like our videos, give this video a big old thumbs up. Drop a comment. Let us know what album we should listen to next. And also turn on your post notifications so that you are notified every single time we drop a video.
Right.
All right. All that fun stuff is out of the way. Dad, we're going to listen to some more Kendrick Lamar. Some more Kendrick Lamar. Right. Yes, sir. Also, I mentioned that Kendrick won the Pulitzer Prize for To Pimp a Butterfly. That's actually untrue. That was inaccurate. He won the Pulitzer Prize for this album that we're listening to today.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so he won the Pulitzer for Damn, which he should have. To me, I think he should have won it for To Pimp a Butterfly. But Damn is really awesome too.
Wow.
But I don't know, when I think Pulitzer, it just makes more sense with To Pimp a Butterfly. But whatever.
All right.
Yeah, so many people corrected me, and I appreciate you guys dropping those comments and letting me know I was wrong. Huh? They always get me. It's like I'm almost saying stuff wrong on purpose just to see what they say.
It's all right.
Yeah, it's all good. All right, so like I said, we're going to listen to Damn today as we continue with Kendrick, and we're leading up to his new album that's dropping, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers.
Yeah, I heard about that. I remember I sent that link to you.
Yep.
I was like, oh, you know, I was keeping up with stuff, yes. Right?
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so Damn was his fourth studio album. It was released April 14th, 2017 through Top Dog Entertainment, Aftermath, and Interscope. Album features production from a variety of record producers. If we remember last week when we listened to Pimp a Butterfly, it was pretty much produced by Terrace Martin and Thundercat.
Not a
ton of collaboration. Mm-hmm. They kind of kept that sound throughout the whole album too, that jazzy sound.
Right.
Somebody commented that they did not use one single 808 in Pimp a Butterfly. Which is really interesting.
One single
808. It's a like a bass drum. It's like a really really popular in modern hip hop to use 808s.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that album was completely all live instrumentation, live drums.
No 808s.
Wow. So I thought that was interesting. But yeah, this one is produced. There's a ton of different producers. We got Mike Will Made It, DJ Dahi, Soundwave. And some further contributions from James Blake, Steve Lacy, Bad Bad Not Good, The Alchemist, Ninth Wonder, Rihanna, U2. Yeah, this album's fire.
Okay.
It is also the winner of the Pulitzer Prize, and it's the first non-jazz or classical work to earn the Pulitzer Prize for music. So no rap album has ever won that. So that was
that
is pretty impressive.
That's an elite class right there. I haven't heard this, but I'm assuming that there's gonna be a lot more variety of styles in this album as opposed to the other one.
For sure. Yeah. So definitely it's a completely different sound than what we heard on the last album.
Mm-hmm.
On the last album, they did stay in that jazz pocket, but I think they did, you know, switch it up. I mean, there's just so much. We've covered that. But yeah, this one is definitely more contemporary sounding.
Okay.
It's got the trap sound, which I don't think we've listened to a ton of trap.
I'm not familiar with trap.
I don't even think we have listened to any trap. So I guess Good Kid, Mad City had some trap elements, but
I don't even know what that is. So you're gonna have to school me on that.
So trap, I'll explain trap more when we like get into specific trap music. But yeah, okay. this does have a lot of trap elements to the production.
Okay,
Mike Will Made It is one of the greatest trap producers.
What's his name?
Mike Will Made It.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Mike Will Made It.
Mm-hmm.
Man, these guys come up with some very unique names, but all right.
Yeah, Mike Will Made It.
Mike Will Made It.
He's okay. Dope. Yeah, all right. Super dope. All right. But yeah, Damn is another, I guess, concept album.
Mm-hmm.
Kendrick Lamar, just with his brain, I don't think he can make an album that's not a concept album. He's just too good at it. So this one... I'll just read. An excerpt here from.
Have I heard anything on this album before?
I feel like you might have heard Humble.
Okay.
The song Humble. But yeah, this is basically a lot of people took this album as Kendrick is on another journey, kind of from good to, or from bad to good.
Mm hmm. Yeah, because the other album was like he was in a depression and he was pulling out of.
Mm-hmm.
So now he's all the way out of it.
Yeah, I don't know if it's even if they're like running like the same timeline as the other album. I think this is just kind of a different idea where he's just saying he plays with a lot of like good and bad.
Okay.
Like, humble or prideful. Mm-hmm. You know. Weakness or wickedness is the main line. Okay. So that's kind of the concept of it, like a right. broad stroke of what the concept is.
Right.
We'll go through this and get your thoughts. I'm not gonna like break it down like I did to Pimp a Butterfly. I kind of want you to just kind of hear it and just
feel it.
Tell me, yeah, just all feel right, it and just I'm tell
ready.
Me what you think.
I'm ready because I'm excited.
Did you enjoy To Pimp a Butterfly? Did you get?
I was really surprised. I was really surprised with Pimp a Butterfly because of the jazz element in it.
Mm-hmm.
So much. It was so heavy,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't expect that from a rapper.
Mm-hmm.
And so this guy, and then he was so the lyrics and his rap style and all of that, man, combined together.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, man, this is ingenious.
Yeah.
So and I understand why people love this guy so much because I can embrace him.
Yeah,
you know
for sure.
what I mean. Mm-hmm. And you know me, rappers. I'm like, yeah, this guy, I like him a lot.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah. He inspired me.
Yeah, cool. All right. Well, we will go ahead and get right into this album. The first track here is titled Blood.
Blood.
Blood. Oh, okay. And this is a skit that opens up the album. And on, it is produced by Beacon and Top Dog.
Beacon.
Yep.
Where's his name? Let me see how he spells. Oh, okay, there it is.
Right there. Beacon. All right, here we go. Blood. And I guess I'm just gonna roll right into DNA because it just rolls right into it really good. So DNA is produced by I think Mike Will. Let me see. Yep, DNA is produced by Mike Will Made It, and that is track two. So I'm just going to play the first two tracks in succession. Here we go.
All right. Is it wickedness? Is it weakness? You decide.
Violins.
Can I be of any assistance?
This is so... I can't even describe it.
Seems to me that you have lost something. I would like to help you find it. Your life.
Is it wickedness?
Whoa. Whoa. Man?
Lamar stated his views on police brutality with that line in the song, quote, and we hate the popo, want to kill us in the street, faux show.
Ah, please. Ugh, I don't like it.
All right, actually, I am going to stop it before we go into DNA. That is Blood, track one on Damn. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, it just came in so soft and surreal, and I was like, oh, okay, this sounds good. And the violins was, they was, you know, and he's talking about this blind woman, and he's watching her, I guess, from afar, and she lost something, and he's trying to help her. But then when he helps her, from my take of what I've heard so far, when he tried to help her, she looked up, well, I guess she's blind, but she's talking to him, and she goes, yeah, you lost something. You lost your life. That's wicked, man.
Bam. Then she shoots her.
Boom.
Shoots him.
Then she... So she's the one that shot him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Someone shot him. Either way it goes, he gets shot.
Yeah, he gets shot. And she's the one that says that you've lost your life. And
yeah, it sounds like a setup.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, that's some wicked. That's wicked.
Yeah, what'd you think about that line? Is it wickedness or is it weakness?
Both.
Yeah.
You know, you can attribute that to both. Well,
maybe she's wicked.
I don't even know if that's weakness showing compassion to somebody, because that's what he was doing. He was showing compassion to her. So you can't really define that as weakness.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, some people would look at it as weakness. Some people would. I don't look at it as weakness. I look at him as showing compassion. But his compassion
is what led him.
Yeah. Led to his death.
You're already catching on.
I'm never home.
Yeah. Good job. All right. The next track here is DNA. DNA is produced by Mike Will Made It.
Okay.
And here we go. Ready? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. What about, did you hear the news clip at the end?
Yeah, I was still digesting what just took place, but I heard a little bit of it, and I need to hear it probably.
So that news clip is like from some news people, I think on Fox or CNN or something, and they're talking about his song from the last time we listened to, We Gonna Be All
Right. Right.
We gonna be all right when he has line, and we hate Popo, wanna see us dead in the streets for show.
Oh, okay.
And they're commenting on it, and they actually have another news clip of Gerardo or something saying that hip hop music has done more damage to the black community than something else. We'll get to that, but
whatever.
But yeah, so
yeah, he's whatever.
He's playing on that. So here's right. DNA. Here we go. All
right, cool. I got loyalty, got
royalty inside my. Oh, that's gotta hit hard.
I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Cocaine quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though ambition, flow inside my DNA. I got realness. I just kill shit.
How many times have you listened to this? I got millions, I got riches building in my DNA.
I got dark, I got evil that rot inside my DNA. I got off, I got trouble, some heart inside my DNA. I just win again, then win again, like Wimbledon I serve. Yeah, that's him again, the sound
another,
of the engine is like a bird. You see fireworks and coffee.
Another Wimbledon acknowledgement.
I know just who you are. See, use a bitch, you almost probably switch inside your DNA. All that sucker shit inside your DNA. Had nowhere to stay at 29.
Oh, wow.
I've been so well, hit cartwheel in my estate. And I'm gon' shine like I'm supposed to. Antisocial extrovert. And exit lit mean an extra work. And absentness, what the fuck you hurt? And passiveness never struck my nerve. And that's a riff gonna be this case.
Whoa.
The reason my power's here on earth. Salute the truth and the prophecy. I got loyalty,
got royalty. This is why I say that hip-hop has done more damage to young African-Americans than racism in recent years.
I live a better fuck your life. This is my heritage, all I'm inheriting. Money and power, the mecca, I'm emeritus. Tell me something, you motherfuckers can't tell me nothing. I'd rather die than to listen to you. DNA not for imitation, your DNA an abomination. This how I this when you in the matrix, dodging bullets, reaping what you're sowing, stacking up the footage, living on the go and sleeping in the villa, sipping from a Grammy, walking in the building, diamond in the ceiling, marble on the floors, beaches out the window, peeking out the window, baby in the pool.
Ah!
Girls, only Lord knows.
He's rolling, man.
I'm a dodger paparazzi, freaking through the cameras, eating four daughters, Brock wearing sandals, yoga on a Monday, stretching to the van, watching all the snakes. curving all the fakes. Phone never own. I don't conversate. I don't compromise. I just penetrate. Sex, money, murder. These are the breaks. These are the times. Level number 9. Look up in the sky.
Level number 9.
On the way. Tennis on the way. Kennis on the way. Motherfucker, I got winners on the way. You ain't shit without a buddy on your belt. You ain't shit without a ticket on your plate. You ain't sick enough to pull it on yourself. You ain't rich enough to hit the light escape. Gonna be a faith. Peace to the world. Sex, money, murder, DNA.
Whoa.
All right, that is track number 2.
Dude, I would like to take that song and just run it back like about 5 or 6 times in a row. I mean, because it got so much shit in it, right?
Yeah.
It's like he's just killing it. He's
killing it. Crazy on there.
Yeah, he did.
What'd you think about everything, the beat?
The beat, the message, everything, man. And he was like nailing points after points after points. I mean, real stuff. That, man, I see why people.
Yeah.
And I've only been in the song too. Yeah. This one right here, dude. He's nice.
Yeah, he went absolutely crazy.
I just think he just went like on this particular song right here, he just went full all the way in. He just went nuts. He was like, everything that he was feeling, he put it all into the song, man. Oh, that was tight. That was tight. You liked that, huh?
Oh, I love that song. I loved it.
I was looking at you and you was like, and you knew all the words. I said, how many times have you listened to this song?
I've played this so much. Like as far as like comparing even like To Pimp a Butterfly to this album, this album to me is just more like, I guess, enjoyable to listen to. Mm-hmm. It's not as deep or as complex or as like all that stuff as the other album, which it is very deep and complex.
Right.
But to me, it's just an easier listen.
Right. Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
As a whole, so I'll just say that.
Well, it's got more upbeat to it.
Yeah.
Than the other one. Like the Pimp Butterfly was more like a jazzier type of thing. Mm-hmm. This right here, you know.
Yeah. It's got more of those for sure.
Yeah.
So DNA, you know, he starts at blood in the album intro, and mm-hmm. he sees a blind lady get shot. Then he goes into DNA. So I guess it's
talking about royalty.
Okay.
Is that what he said? I mean, he's got royalty in his DNA.
Yeah. So he's kind of building like on top. So first is the blood, right? And then now it's your DNA, like what makes you who you are, mm-hmm. I guess. So he's coming at it with just like this ferocity and braggadocious, and he's just cocky, and he's just full of himself and saying, you know, how great he is and how shitty other guys are. That's kind of where he's going with DNA. That's what I take from it.
Go back there for a minute, because it said, I live a B, fuck your life, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What is that about?
I live a better life. I'm rolling several dice, fuck your life. He's saying that at the same time as that sample, too, that of the news clip of Gerardo saying that hip-hop music has done more damage to young African-Americans than racism in recent years.
Mm-hmm.
And then, in between that, he's saying, I live a better life. I'm rolling several dice. So to me, he's out of the hood. He's made it in life, and he's still taking chances as, like, a black American. That's kind of where I take that. Like him saying that in between those news clippings.
So who is this, the news clippings? Does this come from Gerardo?
Geraldo. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I guess, that was just him commenting on
Gerardo's comments.
Those are Geraldo's comments on Kendrick Lamar's previous work.
I'm glad Kendrick Lamar checked him.
Yeah.
He needs to be checked at everything he spits out his mouth. Anyway, that's another story.
Word. Okay, so we'll go ahead and roll right into track number 3. Oh yeah, this video is really cool too. It's Don Cheadle.
Yeah.
Don Cheadle.
That's my boy there.
Basically is like interrogating Kendrick Lamar in the music video, and he's rapping every single word for word. It is an amazing video.
Don Cheadle
raps this whole song word to word.
He is so cool.
It's so dope.
I love Don Cheadle.
We'll react to that music video for our Patreon viewers.
Every time I think about John Tito, man, I think about all his greats, but the biggest one that stands out to me was Hotel Rwanda.
Oh, yeah, that was fire. No, he killed that. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Cool.
That's my boy there.
All right, we'll go ahead and roll into track number three. This one is called Ya. And it is produced by Soundwave DJ Dahi.
What's Ya mean?
Yah is
that to me that's short for Yahweh. Is that correct. Short for Yahweh?
Yeah. So okay. Like God.
Yeah.
But it's also people believe that he used it in two meanings. So he means as God. It's also like the very first and easiest word to communicate in every single language.
Oh.
Like every single when you're a baby, like Yah. Yeah. Like it's an affirmative. So okay. He goes from blood to DNA to now your first communication to the world.
Okay.
You know. All right. Cool. Here we go. Yeah. Track number three.
All right.
New shit. New Kung Fu Kenny. I got so many theories and suspicions. I'm diagnosed with real nigga conditions. Today is the day I follow my intuition. Keep the family close, get money for bitches. I double parked the Austin in the red. My mama told me that I'ma work myself to death. My girl told me don't let these hoes get in my head. My world been ecstatic, I checked the signal, they're red. Buzzing, radars is buzzing. Yeah, yeah. It ain't facts no more. My cousin Carl, double word said no more words. And Deuteronomy say that we all been cursed. I know he walks the earth, but it's money to get, bitches to hit. Yeah, zeros to flip. Temptation is, first on my list. I can't resist, Everyone together now, know that we forever buzzing.
Radars are buzzing. Yeah, that was tight.
All right, that is track number three. What do you think about that one, Dad?
I liked it. Because, he referred to a lot of things that I like.
Like what?
Fox News. But then, basically, he addresses real life situations, political landscape, issues that affect people every day, and then he puts it in his songs, and that's what I like about this particular song. Double parked at Aston. Oh yeah, he's flexing right now.
Yeah, he's in the Aston. So I think like this, as far as like the narrative goes on this album, I think this song is kind of like showing again like the two sides of a person, the good and the evil is like, right. He's kind of like bragging a bit and then he's talking about how people are kind of in his ear about stuff. Mm-hmm. And then he kind of like has these thoughts that could be positive if like worked on and like carried out. But then he kind of goes right back to, bragging or saying like he's doing great.
So he's basically he's trying to lay it out there just a little bit, like he's world famous. These are some of the ups and downs that come with his career, and he's just kind of giving you a little insight about what's going on with the decisions he makes, just the things that he goes through from day to day, the things that goes through his mind, the way he calculates and interprets different things as he's going through his journey in his career and personal life too.
So, for sure.
Yeah. Kendrick. All right. I like this song. It was cool. It wasn't one of my favorites so far, but it was a good song. I mean, I could get into it and listen to it and definitely derive some kind of a meaning from that particular song. So
yeah,
it's cool. It's cool.
Also, I wanted to mention at the beginning, we hear that intro, new shit, new Kung Fu Kenny, and it's like a DJ kind of yelling out. Yeah. Are you familiar with Kid Capri?
No, I'm not. But when he started talking about Kung Fu, I said, oh, Wu-Tang Gang would probably like this song.
I'm sure he's inspired by Wu-Tang. But yeah, Kung Fu Kenny is one of his monikers. Mm-hmm. Kung Fu Kenny. But Kid Capri is like this legendary DJ. He used to be the Def Comedy Jam DJ. He's like DJ in, I'm pretty sure he's from New York, and he's like a legend in the game. So to have Kid Capri kind of hosting this album, like usually you hear DJs on mixtapes and like not like big production albums. So it's kind of a nod to the old school to have Kid Capri do this. It's very, very hip hop of Kendrick to do that. So
I don't know. Something just made me think about something about the DJs. This has nothing to do with.
Let's hear it.
I watch this show sometimes. It's with Jamie Foxx.
Mm-hmm.
And you naming these tunes.
Oh, okay. Name that tune. Yeah.
You saw that show before?
I think I've seen an episode or two.
His daughter is the DJ on there.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's dope.
And yeah, she's really good.
Oh, that's cool.
And I'm just wondering, is she at the level with this Kid Capri?
No.
Oh, yeah. I just thought about that guy.
Absolutely.
I think her name was Corinne or something like that.
Okay.
Have you ever saw her though?
No.
She's good.
Man. Yeah, I'm sure she's fantastic. She's not Kid Capri. you gotta do a lot
like
of stuff.
Like I said, it had nothing
Capri.
To do with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I like it though.
I
can't wait to see the comments. That's awesome. Maybe they're gonna come at you instead of me.
Okay.
I'm usually the villain.
Oh.
No, like
I got thick skin, so
no,
I'm
it's all good. All right, so we'll go ahead and roll into the next track here. And I'm sure I'm missing a ton of details on the breakdowns of these tracks. So if you guys know more information about any of these tracks, please, me and my dad love reading these comments where you guys are putting us on game and giving us knowledge about the albums and stuff. So appreciate that. The next track is track number 4. It's called Element.
Okay.
So this one is produced by Soundwave, Ricky Riera, James Blake, Beacon, and Tay Beast. So yeah, this is Kendrick just establishing his dominance in the rap game and calling out all of his peers. And when you rap as good as Kendrick, you can do that as much as you want. All right. Element.
New Kung Fu Kenny. Ain't nobody praying for me. Y'all know what happens on Earth stays on Earth. Here we go.
I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck.
I'm willing to die for this shit. I done cried for this shit. Might take a lie for this shit. Put the Bible down and go out for a knife for this shit. D.O.T. my enemy won't catch a vibe for this shit. Aye, I been stumped out in front of my mama. My daddy commissary made it to commas. Bitch, all my grandma's dead. So ain't nobody praying for me. I'm on your head. Aye, pussy ass nigga, I'ma make it look sexy. If I gotta go hard on the bitch, I'ma make it look sexy. I pull up, hop out, air out, made it look sexy. They won't take me out my element, nah, take me out
I'm
my
allergic
element.
To a bitch nigga, ayy, an imaginary bitch nigga, ayy. 7 figures, hoe, that's slimmer than my bitch figure, ayy. Going digital and physical and all y'all, ayy. Bunch of criminals and money in my phone calls, ayy. Me okay, we let the A1 fly. Death go to Cuba, that's the only option. If I gotta slap a pussy ass nigga, I'ma make him look sexy. If I gotta go hard on a bitch, I'ma make it look sexy. I pull up, hop out, air out, made it look sexy. Gotta hide your hand, just say its name and I promise that you'll see Candyman. Because it's all in your eyes, most of y'all tell lies. Most of y'all don't fade, most of y'all been advised. Last OP I tried to lift a black artist. But it's a difference between black artists and whack artists.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
had a step of pussy.
Change up. That was nice.
It's the one and only the world's greatest, the king.
I had a girl hard on the bitch. I'ma make a lip sexy. I pull up, hop out, air out, made it look sexy. They won't take me out my element. Nah, take me out my element.
All right, that is track number.
I like that change up at the end. It was like just slow that shit down in slow motion. Dude. Take me out my element.
Yeah, what'd you think about that with that?
That's a good song, man. I like that. That was cool. Dude got some mad flow, man. I just didn't when you was telling me about Kendrick Lamar, I didn't know what to expect. And he's really his rap style is really good.
Yeah.
It's real good. I like Element. He was like he no matter what goes on, from what I pulled from this particular song, no matter what goes on, he's gonna stay on point.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not gonna take him out of his element.
For sure.
He's just gonna stay focused.
Yeah, I think kinda as far as like he's kinda saying like in the rap game, like that's my element. Like there's no way y'all could take me out of my element. Mm-hmm. Like, dude, I'm so good at this and I'm so like y'all can't even tie my shoestrings.
Right. You know? Right.
I love this song. This is like one of those. I like working out to this song.
Oh, yeah. I can see that.
A lot of energy.
That's a good workout song.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track. This one is Feel.
Uh-oh.
I don't know if you noticed so far, too. All the titles of the songs are like one word.
Right.
And they all kind of relate to a person, right? Okay. Blood, DNA, God, element, feel, you know. So on and so forth. So that,
a lot of emotions.
Yeah, for sure.
So this is Feel. I imagine this is going to be, we'll see.
Yeah, go ahead. What are you going to say?
I was going to say Feel. I mean, when you think about Feel,
mm-hmm.
you're talking about a person's inner feelings.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to feel something from this song. He's trying to project something that he wants you to feel.
Correct, yeah. Okay. Absolutely. So we will go ahead and get into Feel. This is one of my favorite songs off of here.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, just the rapping on here and just, yeah, his what he's trying to get you to feel and what he's feeling and what mm-hmm. he's explaining what he's feeling is just fantastic.
Okay.
All right, this one's produced by Soundwave. Track number 5, Feel. All
right.
Ain't nobody praying for nobody.
Nobody praying for me.
Ain't nobody praying for me.
You notice they keep saying that?
Yeah, I know.
In that other song they said it to.
Yeah, that's right. Ain't nobody praying for me. Oh. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
This be cold. This music just makes you really think.
Yeah,
and reflect
does.
And stuff.
Yeah.
I feel like a chip on my shoulders. I feel like I'm losing my focus. I feel like I'm losing my patience. I feel like my thoughts in the basement. I feel like you're miseducated. Feel like I don't wanna be bothered. I feel like you may be the problem. I feel like it ain't no tomorrow. Fuck the world. The world is ending. I'm done pretending. And fuck you if you get offended. I feel like friends been overrated. Praying for me. Ain't nobody praying for me. Ain't nobody praying for me. Ain't nobody praying.
Uh-huh.
I feel niggas been out of pocket. I feel niggas tapping their pockets. I feel like debating on who the greatest can stop it. I am legend. I feel like all of y'all is peasants. I feel like all of y'all is desperate. I feel like all it takes is a second to feel like Mike Frost feed him the poison to fill him up in the prison. I feel like it's just me. Look.
Nice one.
I feel like I can't breathe. Look. I feel like I can't sleep. Look. I feel heartless often. Feeling the falling. I'm falling apart with darkest hours lost in. Feeling the void of being employed with balling.
No,
streets is talking. Filling the blanks with coffins. Fill up the banks with dollars. Fill up the graves with fathers. Fill up the babies with bullshit. Internet blogs and poor
pulpit, filling with gossip. I feel like this gotta be the feeling where Pac was. The feeling of an apocalypse happening, but nothing is awkward. The feeling won't prosper, the feeling is toxic. I feel like I'm boxing demons, monsters, false prophets, scheming sponsors, industry promises. Niggas, bitches, honkies, crackers, Compton. Church, religion, token, blacks in bondage. Lawsuit visits, subpoena served in concert. Fuck your feelings, I mean this for imposters. I can feel it, the Phoenix sure to watch us. I can feel it, the dream. Pray for him, but who the fuck praying for me? Ain't nobody praying for me. Who praying for me? Ain't nobody praying.
That was deep. You know what? That last little verse, right before it concluded, I felt like, man, they should have had like Eminem come in and do that verse right there, man. I was like, you know what I mean? I don't know. That felt like I had an Eminem feel for just a brief moment. Just a brief moment. But that was, man, the dude, he's just like, he's just expressing his feelings about everything he feels about people, the world, everything, man. I like it. I like the tone of it. I like the, I guess the rhythm, the whole thing, the song, man, feel, he made you feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure. Yeah, he's just expressing his feelings about how he doesn't feel like anybody's looking out for him or praying for him, and kind of maybe like a paranoia of some sort, a desire to isolate himself from his friends and family at the same time, but wanting somebody to pray for him is kind of like that duality thing, you know, and that internal struggle.
Yeah, I picked up on something like his grandmother must have passed away, but she was the one she was the one that prayed for him, that he knew that was praying for him, but she's passed away now, so he doesn't have that comfort in knowing that someone's praying for him.
Yeah, yeah, that was a line in one. But that's a good find, because he references that, you know, both his grandmas dead, ain't nobody praying for me, I'm on your head. Yeah, that's the line. Right. Yeah. I love that Kendrick always finds a way to dig into like a depression, like a person that might be depressed or a person that might be dealing with conflicts. So he's kind of covering those things on feel. All right. We'll go ahead and move into the next track.
You didn't know I picked up on that though, did you? You like dad's on some shit. Yeah.
I'm glad you are. That's awesome. So this next track is called Loyalty, and it's produced by Top Dog, Terrace Martin, Soundwave, and DJ Dahi. And this one features Rihanna.
Rihanna?
Yep, Rihanna.
Pregnant. Did she have her baby?
No, she didn't have her baby yet. She's still pregnant.
She's still pregnant? I saw a picture of her, like, yesterday. Like, they were showing her before pregnancy, and then they showed her, like, she had her belly full display and everything. And I was like, oh, look at her.
That's cute.
Yeah.
All right. Ready? Loyalty. Here we go. Track number 6, Loyalty off Damn, featuring Rihanna. Here we go.
All right, cool. Featuring Rihanna. I haven't heard her voice in a long time, actually. So
oh, really?
Cool to hear. Desire. Listen to a lot of Rihanna. Every time I think about her, I think about Chris Brown. That's a good connection, right? Not really, but I mean, that's what I think about. Oh. I don't know about all that. All we ask is trust. All we got is love. Loyalty, loyalty, loyalty. What's the name of the song again?
Loyalty.
Loyalty. Loyalty, loyalty, loyalty. All right. Damn.
Gone for Kenny Nim. My resume is real enough for 2 millenniums. A better way to make a way is not defending them. I meditate and moderate all of my wins again. I'm hanging on the fence again. Hard ass and a bitch on the fast lane. Been a bad bitch with before in the cash game. I'm established, kinda carrots. So my name run the atlas. I'm a natural, I'm a rat. I'm a savage, I'm a asshole, I'm a king. Shimmy out, shimmy out, shimmy out, right. You can tell your nigga he can meet me outside. You can babysit him when I leave him outside.
Ain't no other love like the one I know. Mm. I done been down so long, lost hope. Tenfold, no switching
no
sides.
No switching sides.
You acting shifty, you don't buy.
Uh-huh. Shifty.
I need loyalty. Tenfold, no switching sides. Feel something wrong. You acting shifty. You don't vibe with me no more.
Mm.
It's so hard to be another day, baby.
All right, that is track number 6, Loyalty. What do you think about that one, Dad?
Okay. First thing comes to mind, I want to stay on that before it flees my mind. He said it's so hard to be humble. And you know, you hear people talking about being humble all the time, people with a certain amount of status in this life or whatever, and they try to stay humble. And I can, you know what, it just dawned on me that when you reach a certain level in life, a certain status, such as a guy like Kendrick Lamar, I can see, you think when people talk about humble, you think, oh yeah, I can stay humble. I can be humble if I was at that status in life. But it's not that easy.
Right.
Humble, as you grow in stature and fame and fortune and all of that, humbleness is very, very hard to maintain.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what he's talking. And then he's talking about all the people. Humbleness, that is something that is a struggle with, I can see with, and you see it amongst all the stars and celebrities and everything. I mean, I think a lot of them, they want to try to stay humble,
mm-hmm.
but that's a human weakness that yeah. they have.
Something that you have to battle with.
You have to battle with it every single day.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I agree.
Yeah. So, anyway, great song, great message. I liked it. It was deep.
What'd you think about Rihanna on there?
Rihanna, to me, Rihanna on this song, it was okay. I mean, she didn't really. I mean, he could have done this without her. To me, I mean, anybody could have done this. I mean, he could have plugged in any female, nice female artist on this particular one. Yeah, I don't know. I'll probably get beat up on this. But you know what? To me, she didn't add a lot to the song. It was okay. I mean, but hell, I've heard a whole lot of female artists on some of these other rappers on their tracks that sound just as good as her. I mean, she didn't add anything special to me. I mean, that's my honest opinion. So, I mean, beat me up for it if you want. But that's the way I feel about it. And this is Bridging the Gap, and I'm going to give you my opinion.
Hey, I love it. I love it. All right. So, get Rihanna off of this one.
I was expecting something special, and I didn't get it from her.
Okay, cool. All right. What'd you think about just kind of the message on this one about, you know, loyalty and him? I guess he's kind of... trying to see who's loyal to him,
right.
And
family, friends, mm-hmm. everybody, man. I mean, when you reach his status in life, man, you don't know who. It's hard to trust people.
It's hard to decipher who's for you and who's just trying to use
everybody
you.
Everybody has their motives. Mm-hmm. You know, everybody has an agenda.
For sure.
You never know. So you got to look at that stuff and look at it close and examine people around you.
Yeah. I saw you kind of reacted to that 10-4, no switching sides.
Yeah.
Feel something wrong, you acting shifty, you don't vibe with me no more.
Right, right. Because you know, once he notices, like when he's looking around and seeing, you know, who are the people that are loyal to him, you'd be like, oh, yeah, okay, that mug over there, he's shifty.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I thought he was cool, but he's showing some shifty
behaviors.
Behaviors, mm-hmm. and you're like, oh, okay, we might have to keep an eye on that person.
Yeah. Cool.
So anyway, yeah, yeah.
All right, what did you think about, like, the beat, the production?
The beat was good.
All that stuff.
Everything, the production, it was nice, super nice, super nice. So
cool.
And I'm not going to bother even
long. All right, well, they do talk about it's hard to be humble, and then right at the end of the song they touched on it's hard to be humble, and then the very next song here is titled Pride. So I'm pretty sure that was kind of an intentional line right there to tie tie that line into this next song called Pride, because it's hard to be humble, and the opposite of humble is pride. And again, continuing with the narrative on this album, the dualities, the back and forth, the different sides of the coin. It's hard to be humble because you're dealing with pride. Track number 7, Pride, produced by Top Dog, Steve Lacy, and Beacon. No featured artists, no Rihanna. Don't worry.
Rihanna was cool. It just didn't jump out at me.
Yeah. okay, here we go. Pride. This is kind of another one of the deeper songs on here. I'll just let you hear it. Here we go.
Love's gonna get you killed.
Damn, love's gonna get you killed.
Pride's gonna be the death of you.
Making, spirit breaking, which one would you listen? Beyond they surface world, I don't love people enough to put my faith in man.
There you go.
I put my faith in these lyrics, hoping I make a band. I understand I ain't perfect, I probably won't come around. This time I might put you down, last time I ain't give a fuck. I still feel the same now. We belong here. I know the walls, they can listen. I wish they could talk
indigenous
back. The hurt
becomes
repetition. The love almost lost that.
Hey.
Sick venom in men and women overcome with pride. A perfect world is never perfect, only filled with lies.
All right, that is Pride. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
When I listen to Pride, it was a mixed bag when I listened to Pride. It was hard to follow. And I don't know, is something that a Kendrick thing, because he goes so deep. It's hard to follow about the Pride. I heard some certain parts of it that, okay, I see where he's talking about pride. But then he just goes so deep. I was like, okay, where's he at, you know, with this pride thing. So, I mean, I like the song. I mean, I like the beat. I like the flow. I like the words. It was one particular verse, and I think, yeah, you go up some.
The indigenous people? The indigenous disposition?
Yeah, indigenous disposition, but there was something afterwards. I don't love people enough to put my faith in a man. I put my faith in these lyrics, hoping I make a band. That was like, okay, what's he talking about? I know he's not putting faith in a man, but what is he talking about? I'm hoping I make a band. What's
a band is another word for $1,000.
Oh, see, that's like a rapper term.
Yeah.
Okay. So now you see where he was losing.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. So, now I understand that.
Yeah, Kendrick's the type of artist you definitely have to, like, listen to his music, like, over and over.
And even if I listen to it over and over again, I never would have known what a band was. Okay, so that's $1,000.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Makes sense now.
All right, so we'll go ahead and roll into our next song here. The next track is Humble, track number 8.
I thought we listened to Humble.
Nope, we listened to Pride.
Pride. Oh, okay. Something was, one of the songs talked about being humble. That's what it was.
Yeah. At the end of Loyalty, Rihanna sings, I Try to Be Humble.
All right.
But here we have Humble, produced by Plus and Mike Will Made It. No feature on this one.
That's interesting.
With that, the artwork right there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. it makes more sense too if you actually see the music video, because that's some imagery from the music video. So here we are. Oh yeah, since we're talking about album covers, I didn't ask you, what did you think about the album cover for Damn, for this album?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, not much to think about. I mean, it's not like a whole bunch of, you know, you have to decipher the graphics or the artwork. It's just him, and it just goes, damn. And then, is that a period?
Mm-hmm.
Right there?
Yeah.
That's a period?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well.
What do you think about his demeanor and how he looks?
He looks like something just happened, and he's like, damn.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, like something, you know, he's not too happy about it, maybe. I don't know, but he's like, I can't believe it happened. Damn.
Yeah.
You know?
I like it. Cool. All right, we'll go ahead and go into Humble, track number 8. This is probably the most popular song off of this album.
And this is probably the one that I may have heard.
Possibly.
Maybe.
Yeah. But yeah, it was pretty popular. It was the leading single off of this album.
Okay.
And yeah, here we go. Humble.
Nobody pray for me again.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Nobody pray for me. It been a day for me. Yeah, yeah. I remember syrup sandwiches and crime allowances. Vanessa nickel with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan where my accountant lives, in fact I'm down in this. Douce with my boo babe tastes like Kool-Aid for the analyst. Girl, I can buy your Westie world with my base stuff. Ooh, that pussy good, won't you sit it on my taste buds? I get way too petty, won't you let me do the extras? Pull up on your block, then break it down, we playing Tetris. Bitch, sit down, me on move.
Track number 8, Humble. What do you think about that one, Dad?
That's a good song. I like that. He's just like, what is that? Little bitch? Sit down. Me humble. That's the kind of stuff I'll be picking, little stuff like that. It tickles me. But yeah, it was a good song. I like it. It was some lyrics in there that kind of caught my eye. Where was that? Oh, yeah, get up the fuck out of my stage. I'm the Sandman. Yeah. So they kind of remind me of Apollo, you know, the Sandman come out. Yeah.
Get you off the stage. Yeah.
So I like that, you know, just stuff that I, you know, kind of picked up on and related to. You talk about show me real, give me reels, like show me Richard Pryor with an afro and stuff like that, you know.
Yeah.
He wants natural stuff. He don't want fake stuff. Yeah, yeah, it's a good song. I like it.
Yeah, it's kind of ironic, too, because it's called Humble, and he's saying, be humble, but he's bragging on the whole song. So I think that's, again, like the theme of the two sides of a quarter,
right,
the duality and all that stuff,
right,
like that. So
right.
What'd you think about the beat and that piano?
It was tight
yeah,
to me. I mean, I think it was really, really, he utilized that piano really well. So it kind of brought out the song. And I kind of highlighted the beat, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it was a good song. Like it.
Cool. All right, we'll go ahead and roll into track number 9, which is titled Lust. This one is produced by Bad Bad Not Good.
Oh, Bad Bad Not Good.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm going to start a name. I think I'm going to give me a nickname. I got to figure out something. Like, you know, Bad Bad Not Good. I got to think of me something. Start, you know.
Yeah.
Man, that's wild.
Bad Bad Not Good, Soundwave, and DJ Dahi. This one is No features on here, just Kendrick.
All right.
And this one's titled Lust. So, you know, just building on the narrative of all these titles, just kind of tackling that different part of the human experience. Mm-hmm. Here is Kendrick Lamar on Lust.
This in my down, might as well overheat. Too close to comfort. That's blood rush, my favorite thing.
His favorite thing.
Heartbeat racing like a junkies. I just need you to want me, and my accent too much. Let me put the head in.
I don't want more than that. Girl, I respect the cat. I promise just a touch.
Let me put the head in.
Said it's okay.
Yeah.
Wake up in the morning thinking about money, kick your feet up. Hop in the shower, put on your makeup, lace your weave up. Touch on yourself, call up your nigga, tell him his shit. Credit card scam, get you a visa, make it pay your rent. Hop on the ground, flex on the bitches that be hating on you. Pop you a pill, call up your bitches, have them waiting on you. Go to the club, have you some fun, make that ass bounce. It's whatever, just make it
I
count.
Need some water.
Something came over me. Too hot to simmer down. Might as well overheat. Too close to comfort. That's blood rush, my favorite thing. Heartbeat racing like a junkies. I just need you to want me, and my accent too much.
I like that beat.
Let me put the head in.
I don't want more than that.
I hear you, bro.
Let me put the head in.
I think every dude can relate to that, huh?
I wake in the morning, my head spinning from the last night. Both in a trance, feelings are dead, what a fast life. Manager called, the lobby call is 11:30. Did this before, promised myself I'd be an hour early. Room full of clothes, bag full of money, call it loose change. Bump on my jewelry, 100K, I lost a new chain.
Oh, no.
Bird, hit the next city for another M. Take me a nap and do it again. We all woke up, trying to tune to the daily news. Looking for confirmation, hoping election wasn't true. All of us worried, all of us buried in our feelings deep. None of us married to his proposal, make us feel cheap. Stale and sad, distraught and mad, tell a neighbor about it. Bet they agree, parade the streets with your voice proudly. Time passing, things change, reverting back to our daily program. Stuck in our ways, lust. Lately I feel like I'm lusting over the face.
That's
lately
nice
we lust on the same routine of shame. Lately my lust been heightened.
Lately
it's all contradiction.
Lately I'm not here.
Lately I lust over self.
Lust turn into fear.
Lately in James 4:4 it says friend of the world is enemy of the Lord.
Brace yourself.
Lust is all
I
yours.
Need some water.
Something came over me. Way too hot to simmer down. Might as well overheat. Too close to comfort. That's blood rush, my favorite thing. Heartbeat racing like a junkies. I just need you to want me, and my accent too much. Let me put the head in.
Ooh, I don't want more than that. Girl, I respect the cat. I promise just a
cat. Let me put the head in.
If it's okay,
she said it's okay.
All right, that is track number
like
9, Lust. What you think about that one?
I like that song, man. It was cool. I like it. It's just like it had a real nice beat, and it had like a sinister kind of feel to it, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And
kind of spooky, like,
yeah,
like eerie almost, yeah.
Yep. It's a good song. Yeah.
What did you think about kind of the theme of the song, Lust?
The theme of the song was point. It was on point. I mean, he talked about all the stuff that, you know, he thought, you know, he lusted for, and pretty much that pretty much fits a lot of in general men and women, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I like to. I loved that song right there. I would like to revisit, you know, hear it again. Like if we could play that over again,
mm-hmm.
like do a do over, like. Hear the song and then do it again. That's one of those songs right there. That's
yeah.
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 boom, boom, that nice little beat to it and stuff.
And then when the violins come in,
yep,
and that second part,
yep,
yeah, it's fire.
Yep,
it built. It has a really good build up. Like he like does the verse, and then he kind of like he does like a part of a verse, and then he like runs it back, and then it's still building, mm-hmm, and then he does another part of verse, and then they. And then he finally does the full first verse.
Right, right.
When it's the like beat teasing like, you taps in, mm-hmm, and it's like, oh, okay, okay. Mm-hmm. But yeah, he's talking about like, you know, a guy following his lusts in life, and then a woman following her lust, and then on the hook, you know, he's talking about like a lusty like sexual experience, and him, mm-hmm, trying to convince a girl to just let him, you yeah, know, yeah, just a touch, you know, let me put the head in. But yeah, I mean, but he just does it so in such a dope way that literally every time you listen to this song, like you'll catch something else that's like,
yeah,
yeah.
And I like that one little hook where you go hit a lick.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Hit a lick.
Yeah.
Don't go to work today.
Yeah. I like that. Yeah. I like that.
That was dope. Cool. And then he did it from the female's perspective. Like, go, you know, go hit up, go talk to your homegirl, put your makeup on, uh-huh, lace your weave up, touch it yourself.
Yeah, lace your weave up.
Call
yeah,
up
yeah,
your nigga, tell him he ain't shit. Yeah. He nailed that.
Yeah, he did.
That Lust is probably my favorite song on this album.
Is it?
Yeah, I would say so. Okay. I just love that song. It's low key, it's vibey, it's, you know what I mean? It's, mm-hmm, you know what I mean? I just love that song. At any point in time, I put on Lust and really enjoy it.
Cool.
All right, we'll go ahead and roll into the next song here, which is titled Love. See what he did there?
Uh-oh.
See, it was Lust and then
Love.
Now
we going deep.
Yeah. Again, carrying on with the duality of this album, you got Lust and then you got Love, you know, the
right,
two sides
right,
of the coin. This one's produced by Top Dog, Greg Kirsten, Soundwave, and Teddy Walton.
Okay.
It features Zachary on additional vocals. Mm. I think I really love Zachary's voice. And I believe Zachary is signed to Top Dog Entertainment as well.
Okay.
All right, here's track number 10, Love.
Down.
Love and lust.
Down.
All of them.
Give me a run for my money. There is nobody, no one to outrun me.
Another world premiere.
So give me a run for my money. Sipping bubbly, feeling lovely. Living lovely. Just love.
I'd rather you trust me than to
lovely.
Keep it a whole 100. Don't got you, I got nothing. Hey, I got something.
I got something.
Hold up.
We gon' function.
No
assumption. Feeling like Tyson with it. Knock it out twice, I'm with it. Only for the night, I'm kidding. Only for life, yeah. Only for life, yeah. Only for life, let's get it. Hit that shoulder lean. I know we're coming over me. Backstroke overseas. I know what you need.
Already on. Look what you made. Told you that I'm on the way. I'm like an exit away. Yep,
yep. If I didn't ride blade on curve, would you still?
Uh-huh.
If I'm in my mind at work, would you still?
Uh-huh.
Keep it 100, I'd rather you trust me than to.
Right.
Keep it a whole 100. Don't got you, I got nothing.
It's got a nice flow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like this.
Yeah.
Okay, you said that last song was your favorite one. So far, what I heard,
mm-hmm,
this is my favorite one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it. I like the words. I like what he's saying. I like the flow. It was just like, you just get into that. Just like, just roll with it, man. Just close your eyes and just, yeah.
Yeah, that song is definitely a vibe for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Like the instrumentation of that is just like
it is
so good,
so good,
and all the little different little percussion sounds that they kind of put in there.
Yeah, that was a complex song. I mean, as far as production,
yeah,
it's pretty complex. I like it though, man. It was nice. I like that. That was my favorite so far.
Yeah.
Out of the what we heard.
Yeah, and I think he's kind of alluding to his wife and his love for his wife and like how they met at a young age and stuff like that. And it's just a much more like sincere take on love than the previous Lust.
Right, exactly.
So I think they're great songs, like back to back. But yeah, love that song. Oh, what'd you think about Zachariah?
Now, Zachariah,
mm-hmm.
when I compare it to
Rihanna, yeah.
He had a definite impact on this song right
okay,
here.
Okay, okay. And those are the two songs that have like a singing feature.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Zachariah did the whole hook, and Rihanna, she had a verse, and then she also did the hook with Kendrick.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a fair comparison. I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at that. I like that take.
All right.
Because they're similar, you know, they're in the similar realm of type of song and stuff.
Yeah, and like I said, if I was going to compare the two, you know, he's going to put on a track.
Mm-hmm.
I think Zachariah had a more impact on his song.
On that song than Rihanna had on her. On Loyalty. Mm-hmm. Cool. I'm not mad at that. I don't think anybody can be bad at that. That take right there.
All
right. That's solid. All right. We'll go ahead and roll into one of the hardest hitting songs on here. I don't know if you remember
XXX.
If you remember that song on Good Kid Mad City, I was like, man down, where you from, nigga?
Oh yeah. I like this song.
That was like really like one of the hard hitting joints, you know, and he's saying a lot of stuff in there, but then it's also like just one of the hardest hitting. This to me is like this album's version of that.
Oh, is that right?
That feeling.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So let's roll with that one. I'm gonna hear that.
I like this joint. This one's featuring U2 and it's produced by Mike Will Made It, Soundwave, DJ Dahi, Top Dog, and Beacon. So classic rock group U2 joins Kendrick on XXX. Here we go.
All right.
America. God bless you if it's good to you. America, please take
like harmonies, man. Mm-hmm. Like that.
Can you help me understand?
Throw a steak off the dock to a pool full of sharks, he'll take it. Leave him in the wilderness with a sworn nemesis, he'll make it. Go to the court like, bitch, I did that x-ray. Johnny don't wanna go to school no more, no more. Johnny said books ain't cool no more. Johnny wanna be a rapper like his big cousin. Johnny caught a body yesterday out hustling. God bless America, you know we all love him.
Yesterday I got a call like from my dog, like 101. Said they killed his only son because of insufficient funds. He was sobbing, he was mobbing, way belligerent and drunk. Talking out his head, philosophing on what the Lord had done. He said, kid, I can't body kill my son, that means somebody getting killed. Uh-huh. Tell me what you do for love, loyalty and passion of all the memories collected, moments you can never touch. I wait in front of niggas, spot and watch him hit his block. Uh-huh. I catch a nigga leaving service if that's all I got. I chip a nigga, didn't throw the floor in his lap. Walk myself to the court like, bitch, I did that. Ain't no black power when your baby killed by a coward. I believe in keep the peace. Don't you fuck up 1 hour. It be murder in the street. It be bodies in the hour. Ghetto rapping on the street. Paramedics on the dial. Let somebody touch my mama, touch my sister, touch my woman, touch my daddy, touch my niece, touch my nephew, touch my brother. You should chip a nigga, then throw the floor in his lap. Matter of fact, I'm about to speak at this convention, call you back.
Ah. You talk a word right there, man.
Going crazy.
Oh, snap. That's cold, man.
It's not a place. This country is to be a sound of drum and bass. You close your eyes to look around.
Hail Mary, Jesus and Joseph. The great American flag is wrapped and dragged with explosives. Know you married to blood, I'll ask again. Who
oops, accident. It's nasty when you set us up, then roll a dice, then better.
It's not a place.
Yeah.
This country is to be a sound of drum and bass. You close your eyes to look
around. All right, that is Triple X featuring U2. What'd you think about that one, Dan?
Short, brief, to the point. It was good. It was good. I like the beat. I like the message. It's a pretty good song.
The funny thing is, I like that you use the word short and brief because it's actually a 4-minute song, which is a pretty long song.
Yeah, it is. I didn't know it was 4 minutes.
But
though.
That's so interesting that you said that because it moves around so much and it's packed in.
It didn't seem like a 4-minute
changing. And
it didn't seem like a 4-minute song. It seemed like a 2-minute song.
Right.
You know?
I love that.
Oh, that's wild.
I love that you said that. Right. Yeah, 4 minutes of just absolute fire, rage, excitement.
Mm-hmm.
Bono comes in there and smooths it out with that hook. It's not a place.
It was fire,
it's more like
man.
A song of drum and bass. Like, Kendrick touches on police brutality, gang wars, American terrorism, politics.
Oh, I love it.
I mean,
he just goes. He goes across the board.
Crazy.
Dude.
Yeah. So I think in the. In the storyline or the concept of the album, this is the part where I guess like you take like your identity, like as a, like you've grown up now and you're as an adult, you're kind of wrapping your mind around the world. You're in your country alliance and your political views and your religious views. And I think that's kind of what Triple X is.
Yeah, that's real life, man. As you get older, your perspective changes about the world you live in, and you get a broader view, you get a more in-depth view as you get older and stuff like that. Because really, when you're younger, who cares? You don't give a shit. I mean, it's just like, it's all about you.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, good song.
I love that you're saying that too. Is like it's because he was. It seems to me like he was younger at the beginning of the story or the beginning of the album, and then you know he's going through all of these changes, and then the two songs before this are Lust and Love, right? And then this one is Triple X. So if in the context of lust, love, and then Triple X,
he's maturing through that whole
those
processes. He's gaining a more in-depth view of things, going through the lust, the love, and now Triple X. And
I'm thinking, I don't know if this is a stretch, but maybe even kind of saying that in a song, like it's like the world's fucking you.
Pretty much. He's saying that.
Without saying those exact words, but Triple X is like the world exploiting you or, you know, that kind of idea.
Yeah, but he don't feel the impact like the little guys.
Well, but he was a little guy.
Was.
Yeah, and he still has family and people that he knows.
Yeah, but the family's not hurting. He's not hurting. His family ain't hurting. But what I'm saying, I get what you're saying.
Okay, go.
I get what you're saying. But yeah, he still, to me, that's where it comes back to humble.
Mm.
Because he can still view things in a He looks at the world, has a world perspective, like he can still view things in a humble man's point of view.
Yeah.
Because even though he's reached this plateau in his life
where
a lot of the stuff he's talking about don't really affect him anymore
or
his immediate or close family.
Because
money, you know, he's got money now, right?
Okay, well, just to dispute that a little bit, on To Pimp a Butterfly and on the original album, more so on To Pimp a Butterfly, he talks about his three friends that were killed while he was on tour.
True, yeah, I remember that.
Due to gang violence. Mm-hmm. And he talks about how he didn't even make it to the hospital. He tried to FaceTime.
Right.
And he was upset with himself about that.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't you say that's still these type of issues affecting him in a very close way?
Yeah, yeah, it does. But I still say that, you know, with his status where he is now, he's still far removed from that. You know what I mean? I mean, even though those things happened, those his boys, whatever, it hit him. But and it's not like, man, it's hard to articulate it. But it's not like once you got money, man, you it still removes you from the immediate or the hard impact of a lot of things, even tragic things.
I agree. It
to a certain degree.
It would take away a lot of those issues, but something like death, you know.
Yeah, it's going to affect everybody the same way. Yeah. Pretty much. I get it. Yeah. Okay, I understand.
Something like that. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's just one example of something that can still affect a person's, you know, emotional and mental well-being.
Absolutely. And I still think that mentally he's still, even with this album, I saw that his how fragile he was on the first album, Butterfly, because he was going through a whole lot of mental battles.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see right here, the mental battles are still happening, but he's learning to deal with them and master them better for his advantage to uplift himself and the people around him and make himself a more whole person.
Yeah, totally.
And so, I still see the mental battle, though, but then we all have mental battles.
For sure. So. And that's why I think his music is so universal, because he speaks about these things in a specific way, but he also speaks about them in a widely general way, to where, you know, whatever your situation is, you know, you could feel him,
right?
You know, and you can.
Yeah, I think that's where he gains his popularity is that when you listen to his music, people would say, "Oh man, that's me."
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's me. I can relate to that.
Right, and even if you didn't grow up the same way as him or go through the same exact things that he went through, he still can like strum on those emotional chords, and he, you know, relates. Yeah, cool. All right, that was a nice little blurb we just had.
Yeah, it was.
That was very podcasty.
It was podcasty.
Yeah, would you guys be down for a Bridging the Gap podcast? Let us know in the comments.
Yeah.
All right, we'll go ahead and move on to track number 12. This one's called Fear.
Uh-oh. I know he's gonna go on a tangent on this. Yeah. One, I feel like.
Yeah.
Is he? Is he is.
He's going to do his thing.
I knew it.
Fear, this one is produced by Beacon and The Alchemist. Ooh, The Alchemist.
I've heard that on another album. He was on another. Yeah, whose album Alchemist. Was that?
Who has he produced that we've listened to? I know he's produced some stuff. Oh, man.
Was it Outkast?
Nah, that's Organized Noise. They pretty much work in-house.
It wasn't.
It might have been, was it 50?
That's what I was getting ready to say, maybe, too. I thought it might be 50.
It might have been 50. That kind of makes sense. I don't know. If you guys know what we listened to that had Alchemist on it, let us know in the comments.
Eminem was it?
I don't think so. Nah. Because Eminem, he produces it or it's the Bass Brothers.
Oh, okay.
Dang.
I can't think of what either.
Is it? That's going to bother me. Please, you guys, let us know what we listened to. The Alchemist produced.
Maybe we just research Alchemist and then it'll list all of the people he featured. Maybe
we could look it up. But yeah, Alchemist, legendary, dope producer. So super hip hop, and like this is before Kendrick's time. Alchemist, Kid Capri, like these guys are.
They already veterans.
Yeah, so it's Kendrick paying homage to the hip-hop community by bringing in a Kid Capri, by bringing in an Alchemist.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very, like, just dope hip-hop thing that he's doing here. Okay, so.
All right, cool.
All right, yeah, Alchemist, Fear, Kendrick Lamar, track 12, here we go.
I know you've been having a lot on your mind lately, and I know you feel like, you know, people ain't been praying for you.
I want to fret, What the hell?
What is that?
It's words in reverse.
I beat your ass, keep talking back. I beat your ass, who bought you that?
You know
you
stole it.
I beat your ass if you
say
that game is broken.
What?
I beat your ass
Beatles
if you jump on my couch.
I
beat your ass if
they
you walk in this
demonic
house with tears in your eyes running from poo poo and Prentice. Go back outside, I beat your ass, little nigga. That homework better be finished. I beat your ass, your teachers better not be bitching about you in class. That piece better not be wasted, you eat it all. The TV better not be loud if you got it on. Them Jordans better not get dirty when I just bought them. Better not hear about you humping on Keisha's daughter. I been out here, you got caught up. I beat your ass, you been roll that motherfucker up. And then I take two puffs.
Two
I'm
puffs.
High now. I'm high now. I'm high now. I'm high now.
Life's a bitch, pull them panties to the side now.
To the side now.
I probably die anonymous. I probably die with promises. I probably die walking back home from the candy house. I probably die because these colors are standing out. I probably die because I ain't.
I roll that motherfucker up.
And then I take two puffs.
I've been hungry all my life.
I'm high now. I'm high now. I'm high now. I'm high now.
Life's a bitch, pull the panties to the side now.
When I was 27, I grew accustomed to more fear. Accumulated 10 times over throughout the years. My newfound life made all of me magnified. How many accolades do I need to block denial? The shock from it will make them highlight my simplest lines. I'm talking fear. Fear losing creativity, I'm talking fear. Fear missing out on you and me, I'm talking fear. Fear losing loyalty for pride, cause my DNA won't let me involve in the light of God. I'm talking fear. Fear that my humbleness is gone, I'm talking fear. Fear that love ain't living here no more, I'm talking fear. Fear that is wickedness or weakness.
Humbleness, love,
whatever it is, both is distinctive. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth, and I can't take these feelings with me, so hope
so. Verse 2 says, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities. So until we come back to these commandments, until you come back to these commandments, we're going to feel this way. We're going to be under this curse. Because he said he's going to punish us, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, states of America. I love you, family, and I pray for you. God bless you.
Shalom. All right, that is Fear. What did you think about that one, Dad?
That song was so deep. And I was saying that other song, Love, was my favorite. But, dude, I got to put that up next to that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
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 There's a lot. There's a lot on this song. I think this song kind of brings the whole album full circle. Mm-hmm. It pretty much touches on his, and he, like, created this song really dope, like, the first verse is him rapping from his mom's perspective, and he's 7 years old, and she was instilling fear in him. And then the second verse is him when he's 17 and his fears as a black youth in a inner city neighborhood, all the ways that he could die.
Yeah, and I was like, damn, it's like either way he turns. Nowhere, I mean, is no, I mean, whatever direction you choose to turn, the list of things he talked about, it was all like for real that he could possibly die in those scenarios. I mean, easily, you know, and I was like, damn, man, that's like, as I thought about it, he's still listening to all those things. I was like, whew, I can even relate to that. I mean, damn, for real.
Yeah. Yeah,
but you never think about it while you're living it.
Mm-hmm.
But then when you look back on it, like the way he laid it out, I'm like,
could have died from any of those things.
Any of those things. Yeah, yeah.
So. Yeah. Second verse, super deep. And then the third verse is him kind of bringing the album into perspective and then just breaking down his fears as his current life is. or you know, his superstar life at 27. He was just fearful of all the ways he could go broke. He was fearful of losing creativity or the people not feeling him or his reputation suffering. Mm-hmm. And that's even something he talked about quite a bit on To Pimp a Butterfly too. Mm-hmm. You know, those fears that haunt him and stuff like that. And I think he kind of, at the end, to me, the resolution is that, you know, he just needs to put his faith in God. And that's pretty much what can alleviate his fears.
Yeah. I mean, you know, some of those fears are probably things that has driven him to stay on top of his game, too.
Mm.
Because you got to have a certain, you can't be relaxed when you're an entertainer. Like,
yeah, you don't want to get complacent.
Yeah. So, I mean, that some of that fear was positive fear.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you know. I agree. Cool. All right. And then what'd you think about kind of his cousin Carl calling him at the front and the end of the track?
It was Cousin Carl got wisdom, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he dropped some bomb wisdom on him. You know what I mean?
For sure.
Cousin Carl.
Cousin
Everybody
Carl.
Everybody needs a Cousin Carl.
Yeah, definitely. And then, yeah, Kendrick always does use, like, biblical references, Bible mm-hmm. verses. You know, he uses this passage from his Cousin Carl to kind of enforce some of the narratives that he's trying to bring in with the Bible and stuff.
Right.
Also, he references Deuteronomy a couple of times on this album.
Yeah, I noticed that.
So people that study this album, you know, put there, I guess there's more than one, you know, reference and, you know, aligning with Deuteronomy.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
that's just some more background. All right, the next track is titled God. And this is track number 13.
All right.
I think that's interesting. Fear God.
Mm-hmm.
Fear then God. Man, this guy's good.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, he is. For real.
That's a trip.
He knows. He knows what's up. He just. You know what? He knows. He's on a higher level. He's giving you like tidbits because you can't handle.
If he really wanted to go all the way, and yeah. that's what I'm saying. Like I feel like To Pimp a Butterfly was him really going there, but then he was like, okay,
they can handle.
Let me dumb it down a little bit.
Because
yeah, this is just like
right.
Like I'm looking at the track list, right? Blood, DNA, y'all, element.
Mm-hmm.
And then feel loyalty, and then pride and humble. Like they just all like
they feed off of one another.
Flow
they
kinda, right yeah, into yeah. love, lust, triple X, mm-hmm. fear God. Wow,
yeah,
so cool.
Yeah. It's like,
all right, track number 13, God, produced by Cardo, Soundwave, DJ Dahi, Top Dog, Beacon, Ricky Riera.
Well, you got a lot of collabs on this, huh?
Yeah, Young Exclusive, Teddy Walton, and Mike Hector. Yeah, sounds like a lot of production help on this one.
Cool, cool.
All right, here we go.
This what God feel like. Yeah. Laughing to the bank like ah ha. Y'all gotta see that I one man. Slick as out of bars with the finger waves. Work a JG. Handle bars like a fade. Watch me work a JG. I'm at large running plays like a circuit JG. I'm selling versus JG. Watch me work a JG.
La la. Hold up.
Don't judge me, my mama caught me with a strap. And y'all gon' see, this what God feel like.
Hell,
laughing to the bank like, ah, hell, flex on swole like, ah, hell, you feel some type of weight then, ah, fuck is you talking to?
Hey, do you know who you talking to? Slide on you like falling drapes. God, toys full of carnivals. I kill him with kindness, or I kill him with diamonds, or I put up like 1500. Get your ass killed by the finest. Everything, life is a gamble. Nothing in life I can't handle. Seen it all, done it all, felt pain more. For the cause, I done put blood on sword. Everything I do is to embrace y'all. Everything I write is a damn eight ball. Everything I touch is a damn gold mine. Everything I say is from an angel.
I know bloodshed, fuck shit, always your shit, my shit. Getting boss to ignite shit. Walking to the night shift, I'm home.
I ain't sorry for it. Ask for a peace of mind.
Yeah. Got you like laughing to the face like, ah, ah. Ah, ah. Flex on smoke like, ah, got you like. Yeah, that's what got you like. You feel some type of way then, ah, ah.
All right, that is track 13 or 14. God, what'd you think about that one, Dad?
I didn't know what to expect when I saw the title.
Mm-hmm.
And definitely he took it to a place where I didn't know, like I said, I didn't know what to expect.
Mm-hmm.
But then he says, God, that's what God feels like, taking it to the bank.
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, ah, like God's laughing while he getting paid or something, you know what I mean? I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
Good song. Dude's got a vivid imagination, is all I can say.
Yeah.
What'd you think about it?
Yeah, I don't really...
See? Yeah, it's like,
this one actually is one of the ones, like, at surface level, it feels like it should be, the more simple one. But to me, this one just kind of... Because he's, like, on the last track, he's, like, comes to this resolution that all his fears and anxieties can be settled by looking to God, right?
Right.
But then he comes on to this song, and he's bragging about his success.
And God's tripping. I mean, well, he's comparing God's it, like, tripping, like, he's laughing and saying...
I think he's comparing it to saying, like, this is what being God feels like.
Yeah. Okay.
I think that's what he's saying. but it's just such a...
For him to arrogant. Say God goes... Ah, you know, people are like, oh, that's a trip. Okay, but
I just think it's an interesting turn from where he resolves the last track.
Yeah.
Like, okay, I'm resolve my fears and anxieties by looking to God, and then you go to the next song and compare your success to feeling like God. It's just like a,
yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm missing something. Might be missing something.
Well, maybe. As they was trying to explain that, you know, some of these rappers think they God.
Mm-hmm. So, right. So that's what I'm saying. Like in the
hearing, they're not in charge. It's basically what it says. It says they some of these rappers see themselves as God, but they really don't know they're not in charge. Is that what he's?
Oh, okay.
See that?
So maybe he's like, just pointing out, like, okay. I get it. Yeah. I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
He's just kind of pointing it out, like, these guys, this is how they feel, but at the end of the day, like, you're not actually in control. Okay.
Right.
Maybe
right.
I'm missing what he's saying in the verses then.
God talks full of carnivals. I kill him with kindness. I kill him with diamonds. Yeah, man, this dude, man, he's just like so.
Oh, okay.
He so sprinkled with so much freaking knowledge in his verses, man. It's just like, yeah, you gotta just sit down and almost study this shit like a class.
No,
you know?
Seriously.
You know,
I'm
a
sure
class on Kendrick Lamar.
They're gonna get at me. They're gonna explain God and they're gonna school us on what God means to this album.
Okay.
So
all right.
I'm looking forward to that. Y'all put me on. Let me know how that, like, I get it. Like,
I'm interested in knowing what everybody else's take is
for
on
sure.
That too.
That's the other thing. People could take it so many different ways. That's you know, he leaves it up to interpretation. Okay, the last song here is called Duckworth. And this song is so cool, Dad.
Duckworth.
Yes.
Mm.
He's telling a story basically about how his CEO, Top Dog, he's signed to Top Dog Entertainment. Mm. His CEO, his name Top Dog. He actually met his dad, Kendrick's dad, during a robbery.
Kendrick met his dad.
No, Kendrick's dad met Top Dog before Kendrick was a rapper and before Kendrick was signed to Top Dog Entertainment.
Uh-huh.
Kendrick's dad and Top Dog met each other because Top Dog was robbing a KFC that Kendrick's dad worked at.
Shut up.
True story. So that's what Duckworth is about.
Get the hell out of here.
Listen to this story.
Oh, the other thing I want to say about this last song, The God, with all those collaborations on it,
yeah,
the music changed. The production changed. It was a whole lot of different kind of things going on with the music.
Uh-huh.
And I liked the way what they was doing. It was like you could tell that there was a collaboration
uh-huh.
with the musicality of that particular song.
For sure.
All the change ups, the instruments, the flow of the music. Mm-hmm. It was just, I'm not a musical person, so I really can't tell you like technically what went on with that song, but I could tell you there was a difference
yeah.
in the way that music was when they produced that song.
For sure. Yeah. So. Definitely a lot of collaborations on that production. And yeah, I love the production throughout this whole album. All these songs just have a different texture to them and a different vibe, but they all serve like a really good purpose when they come in. You know, you got your hard hitting ones, and then you got, you know, your more relaxed kind of boom bappy kind of rap beats, and then you got your vibey ones like Love and Loyalty and stuff. So this album's dope. All right, here's the last track. It's called.
I'm going to listen to this again.
Yeah. Actually,
put that on and chill while you know in the kitchen cooking. And,
yeah, for sure.
You know, put that on and just vibe to this whole. Yeah, you got. I want to hear this whole thing all over again.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Here is Duckworth, the final track here.
It was always me versus the world. Until I found it's me versus me.
I hear you.
Stays on
he
earth.
He has said that a bunch of times in here.
We're gonna put it in reverse.
Darling, I told you many times.
Nice help.
And now I'm telling you once again. Just to remind you, sweetheart, that my.
Oh!
Come on. Hail Mary, your marijuana times is hard.
Okay.
Pray with the hooligan, shadows all in the dark. Fellowship with demons and relatives, I'm a star. Life is one funny motherfucker. A true comedian, you gotta love him. You gotta trust him, I might be bugging. Infomercials and no sleep. Introverted by my thoughts, children listen, it gets deep. See, once upon a time inside the Nickerson Garden Projects, the object was to process and digest poverty's dialect. When he turned his back and they killed his cousin, he beat the case and went back to hustling. Bird shuffling, Anthony rang. The first in the projects with the two-tone Mustang. That 5.0 thing, they say 5-0 came. Circling parking lots and parking spots and hopping out while harassing the corner blocks. Crooked cops told Anthony he should kick it. He brushed him off and walked back to the Kentucky Fried Chicken. See, at this chicken spot, there was a light-skinned nigga that talked a lot with a curly top and a gap in his teeth. He worked the window, his name was Ducky. He came from the streets to Robert Taylor home. Southside Project, Chirac, the Terror Dome. Villainous, devilish work, skeletonous crime, intelligent, villainous, prevalent proposition with nines. Ducky was well aware, they robbed a manager and shot a customer last year. He figured he'd get on these niggas' good sides. Free chicken every time Anthony posted in line. Two extra biscuits, Anthony liked them and then let them slide. They didn't kill him, in fact it looked like they're the last to survive. Pay attention, that one decision changed both of their lives. One curse at a time, reverse to manifest a good karma. And I tell you why, you take two strangers and put them in random predicaments. Give them a soul so they can make their own choices and live with it. 20 years later, them same strangers you make them meet again. Inside recording studios where they reaping their benefits. Then you start reminding them about that chicken incident. Whoever thought the greatest rapper would be from coincidence? Because if Anthony killed Ducky, Top Dog could be serving life while I grow up without a father and die in a gunfight.
Damn. Yes, stop it.
So I was taking a walk the other day.
He's clouded. He be teasing your mind. He be playing with you like, y'all, okay, I'm just going to give you a little bit of the knowledge I know, because y'all can't handle all this shit I know. So I'm just going to give it to you, break it to you light, give you a little taste. Well, that story was good about Duckworth.
That was track 14, Duckworth. What'd you think about that one?
It was good, man. I like that story, man. Yeah. That was tripping. Dude. He's like, yeah, he said he's going to get extra biscuits now. Yeah, it was a good story, man. It was and that is a true story. It makes it even better. You know
yeah.
what I mean?
There's such
how
a
life
crazy
circles back around, man.
Yeah, so Anthony grew up in the neighborhood. He was raised by pimps and hustlers.
But I'm going to tell you, man, that reverse shit that he'd be doing, man, that freaks me out. I don't like that. I don't like that shit, man.
Well, okay, so I'm going to break it. I'm going to give you another little nugget about this album. So he made this album to be able to be played 1 through 14,
mm-hmm.
but you can also play it 14 through 1, and it makes perfect sense in the opposite order. So that's why at the end, mm-hmm. he rewinds it and goes back to the beginning. I was taking a walk the other day.
Okay, but I told you what that reminds me
yeah,
of.
Yeah, yeah, especially on that other one where it wasn't serving
that purpose.
They used to say,
I think it was the Beatles. They said if you played it, it had a demonic a message to it. If you played the Beatles, you do the album, you know, in reverse.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what that reminded me of. So I'm like, man, you don't be creeping me out and shit. You know what I mean? But yeah. I see what you're saying. And when you put it in that perspective, then I'm cool with it. But,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
they've said that
about a lot of
artists
and different songs and stuff. Play it backwards. It says, I love Satan or something like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the end of the album. What do you think about the album overall?
Overall, excellent. Excellent. Cream in the crop. I had to give it to him. Like I said, I'm going to go home and I'm going to be putting this on, you know, while I'm in the kitchen, you know, cooking up something to eat tonight. And I'm just going to be like vibing to this. I got to play that again.
Yeah.
I got to hear it again.
Mm-hmm. So we've listened to 3 Kendrick Lamar albums so far. Good Kid, Mad City, To Pimp a Butterfly. And now Damn. What do you think
about Kendrick?
About Kendrick as a whole, or
does not disappoint.
Maybe his projects individually, or
Kendrick does not disappoint. Now, like you know, I've you give me some flavor of the other rappers and stuff like that, and I certainly do still appreciate some of the others you've introduced to me. I think he has to rise to the top as far probably one of my favorites. I still love 50.
Mm-hmm.
I love 50. And Eminem is my boy, man. He's just crazy, nuts old crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
I love. But then, you know what? I think some of the other rappers, like ones that really surprised me was Outkast.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I didn't think that. I didn't ever look at them as, I guess, rap. You know, because of some of the songs that were mainstream didn't really
mm-hmm.
strike me as being, you know, rap or hardcore rap. And that, but this guy right here, Kendrick, man, I think I put him and, you know, Kanye's like, and like you said, I know you said it earlier today, you said something about Kanye is like, when you listen to him, he's like that philosopher, but he lays it out simple for you to understand.
Mm-hmm.
Like Kendrick, when he lays it out, you got to start. You got to do some study.
Yeah.
You know, you not got to really just.
You've literally got to like decode it.
Right.
Like it's so many different themes and parallels he draws and.
Mm-hmm.
It's very, very deep.
And then some of his songs, and you know, you think you got, I know what he's talking about, but then, you know, you listen to somebody else listens to it, and they got a whole different perspective of it, because it has so many layers to it that you can interpret it.
For sure.
So, yeah. Kendrick, man, he's nice. You told me, you said, once you hear the Kendrick Lamar, you was like, you pumped him up, and I was like, he's all right. he's probably going to be all right, but you know what? He's living up to the hype that you provided to me.
For sure. Mm-hmm. I think Kendrick is absolutely one of the most talented rappers to ever rap.
Mm-hmm.
He makes really good songs, really good albums, especially in a day and age where like albums aren't people's like main focus. It's more like they just want to hit single and then they'll put a project out and then just try to duplicate that single over and over again.
Yeah.
But he takes a lot of pride in like making a full project that makes sense and will stand the test of time. And I think his music is doing that. I mean, this one came out in 2017.
Oh, that wasn't that far away. I mean, not too far.
Yeah, 2017, but he hasn't dropped an album since this is his last album. Mm-hmm. So it's been 5 years, and like, it's okay. It's like,
right,
we'll wait for you.
Right, you know, exactly. Because you know it's going to be like
crazy.
It's going to be like, you know, Christmas Day. You know, you unwrapped it. But you know what? I sent you the link. He's got a new one coming out, right?
Right.
Man.
Yeah. That's what we're going to listen to.
When is that coming out?
On May.
This month.
Yeah, it comes out. It'll be out, but we're going to listen to that next week.
Oh.
And
oh,
I'm not going to.
Let me know.
I'm not going to listen to it.
I'm not going to listen to it either, but I mean.
No. I'm telling you, we're both going to listen to it.
Together.
Together for the first time.
Okay.
So.
Oh, that's cool.
It's going to be a completely.
So then I get to pick your mind.
Yeah.
I get to pick your brain and see what you think about it.
We'll have to try to figure it out like real time.
Right.
But I think it'll just be cool to just sit there and just listen to the music and talk about it.
And I can't even imagine what he's going
to
come up
with. I'm so curious to, like, what is it going to sound like? 5 years ago, music sounded completely different.
Right.
For the most part, all the major players were different. You know, it was different sound. So
from what I've heard from him, when this album comes out, I don't think he's gonna disappoint. I think he's gonna kill it.
Oh yeah,
I think he's just gonna kill it, dude. I can't wait to hear it.
It's just so
I'm so hyped. You got me hyped on a damn Kendrick Lamar rapper, man. Who would have thunk?
I know. I think our channel is working.
Yeah,
that was the mission.
You know how I was like, don't turn that shit on in this house. Don't turn it on, man. You take that over there somewhere. Okay.
So you were missing out.
Well, I had my own stuff. So.
Yeah, but you could have had some of this. You could have had some of this. But all right, cool. So yeah, we're look out for our next video, which we're going to be reacting to Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. And also, if you like this video, make sure you give it a big old thumbs up. Drop in the comments, what's your favorite Kendrick Lamar song off of this album, Damn. Also, turn on your post notifications and make sure you are notified every single time we drop a new video. And if you don't like the edits on YouTube and you want our full uncut reactions, as well as access to our additional content, like we're going to watch the Grammys performance that Kendrick did, and then maybe another Kendrick music video or something. If you want stuff like that, that's going to be on our Patreon exclusively at first before it ever goes to YouTube. So, consider supporting us on Patreon. We'd really appreciate it. Mm-hmm. Other than that, that's all I got. You got anything else, Dad, before we get out of here?
All I can say is I can't wait for this next Kendrick Lamar album. That's all I got to say.
Yeah, next time we see you guys, Mr. Morale will be out and we'll be reacting to it. So can't wait for that. We'll see you next time. Bye, guys.